In today's video, we're going to learn how to make an agenda accessible to WCAG 2.1 AA standards. Then we're going to upload it into Streamline and run a scan for accessibility to validate that it is in fact accessible. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. There are many rules and regulations to consider when making Microsoft Word and PDF documents accessible to WCAG 2.1 AA compliance. And I always like to begin with applying headings. Now, the first thing I want to do is open up what's called the navigation window. There's a couple of different ways to do this. We can press Control F on my keyboard and then select the headings button from the navigation panel. Or we can type in the search bar, navigation, and select open the navigation pane. Now, let's begin applying our heading structure. The first and most important heading to apply is the heading level 1. So under my home ribbon, under the styles tab, I'm going to select the heading 1 option. And we have the text applied here. And let's go ahead and center it. And then we have some text under it. Meeting title, accessible, accessibility training session. Let's make this a heading level 2. Oh, whoops, it actually applied it to all of that text. Let's do a Control Z. And what I need to do here is actually add in a couple carriage returns. And then let's go ahead and center this also. So we have our heading level 1 and our heading level 2, and then now we have the date, time, location, and the actual agenda. Let's go ahead and make this actual agenda text a heading level 3, and then it looks like we have some areas where we can apply maybe like some bullets. So let's apply some bullets to welcome and introduction. And then in this example, we actually have timestamps too. So I want my list to be all one list with no spaces in between it, because this is going to help us maintain our accessibility when we take it over to PDF. So let's backspace the time area. I'm going to hit enter and then tab to make a nested list. But one important note, this open face bullet is going to give me trouble. Adobe Acrobat does not like those open face bullets. So I'm going to go ahead and just make it a closed face bullet. Actually, we can go ahead and make this a numbered list also, since we're gonna go in order. We also have presenter Sean Jordison. Again, I'm just going to backspace some of this up. And then let's make overview of section 508 a heading, a numbered list item. And then we have our time. I'm gonna backspace up, hit enter, and then tab over to make this a bulleted list. This keeps my list content nice and easy to understand. We have MS Word accessibility techniques. We could also use our keyboard to make this a number 3. If you use your decrease indent and increase indent formatting in Microsoft Word. And let's go ahead and keep cleaning these up. So now we have a nice looking agenda that has a title, date, location, and a nested list. Let's go ahead and add a dummy Zoom link here. And I'm just gonna put a default link, because I wanna show you how to fix this default link. So we have conference room A, or in the Zoom room. I'm actually gonna take my hyperlink that I just put in there and let's cut it, because we need our on-screen text to be clear and descriptive. So I'm gonna take the Zoom room text, right-click it, and add my hyperlink. And I do that by right-clicking, selecting the link button, and then in the address bar in the bottom of the box, I'm going to paste and select OK. All right, we now have a mostly accessible Word document, but let's go ahead and check our document properties. To do that, I'm going to select the File button and then go to Info, Properties, and Advanced Properties. And let's add in a title. I'm going to say Sample Agenda. And the subject will be agenda, and the author is Sean Jordison, and let's select OK. Let's go back. Now, one final step before we take this into PDF, let's run the accessibility checker. To do that, I'm going to select the review button and then select check accessibility. And over on the far right-hand side, our accessibility assistant says looks good, no issues found. That's amazing. Let's go ahead and save our document. I'm going to do file, save as, and change my name to Agenda Accessible and select Save. Now I'm going to select my Acrobat toolbar and we're gonna create a PDF, and then let's select Save. And now we have our agenda in PDF. The first thing that I always like to do in PDF is select the tags button, and I just want to review the tags panel. First and foremost, we have a document tag. That's amazing. We have an H1, an H2, we have our paragraph text, we have our H3, and our list items. Now, really quick, I want to ensure that my link has alternate text. So I'm going to open up my P tag and right-click my link tag, select properties, and we need to add an alternate description for links. I'm going to add a Zoom room and select close. And because my tag structure already looks amazing, let's go ahead and check our document properties. I'm going to select the menu button and then select document properties. And in here we have our title, author, agenda. Now there's one thing I wanna check in here. Under initial view, under the window options, I wanna make sure that I have document title selected and not file name. Let's select okay, and let's save our file. And then one final step, let's run the accessibility checker. So to do that, I'm going to open up my prepare for accessibility option, select check for accessibility, and we want to check all pages in document and ensure that 32 of 32 categories are selected. If you have like 31 or 30, you can change this drop-down menu to each one of these elements and just make sure all the checkboxes are checked. Then select start checking. And in here, under document, we have logical reading order and color contrast both need manual check. This will forever be this way. So in this example, we can just leave it as is, or we can open up our color contrast analyzer and we can actually test some of our colors. So I do have this dark blue in here, and I can use this eyedropper tool from the color contrast analyzer tool to test my color. So I have this blue text on a white background and it passes our WCAG 2.1 AA standards. So that passes my manual check, and logical reading order is based off the tags panel. So these are forever checked as needs manual check. You can just kind of ignore that it says two issues. Let's open up page content, and it says our tab order has failed. This is simply an error when you convert from Word to PDF. To fix it, you simply right-click the tab order and select fix, and then it will say tab order set to match structure, and we select okay, perfect. Now let's select save. Now let's upload our PDF into Streamline. I'm going to log into my Streamline account, go into my content panel, find the page I want to upload it to, and I'm going to select the edit button. Now from here, I'm simply going to add in my document by selecting the plus button in the main body content, and then selecting file, insert, and then we're going to select and upload a file. And we're going to select our agenda accessible.pdf, hit select, and then save and close. Now we're going to check the accessibility of this document by going to the accessibility tab, selecting our files button, and lo and behold, our agenda accessible is accessible. Yay, good for us. That concludes today's video on how to make an agenda accessible in Microsoft Word and in PDF. And then finally, uploading it into Streamline to validate the WCAG compliance. If you want to find out how I can help you get accessible, or if you want to learn more information about the Streamline platform, take a look at the links in the description of this video. And as always, I can be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.